Hello, and welcome to the East West Ministry of Rock 2 Library. I'm David Earle, and I'll be your host as we explore this innovative collection of rock instruments. Doug Rogers and Nick Phoenix, founders of East West and Quantum Leap, decided to expand on the ideas of their very popular Ministry of Rock series. They completed Ministry of Rock in 2007 and wanted to expand not only the instrument set, but also the flexibility of the library. This turned into a new brainchild, Ministry of Rock 2. For Ministry of Rock 2, the East West team put together a carefully vetted collection of instruments. Among them were the most popular rock drum sets around. They had kits from Gretsch, DW, and Ludwig, and paired together snares from Ludwig, DW, Sonar, GMS, Gretsch, and Tempus. They added more flexibility in the player and the mixer, and gave the ability to swap out different drum pieces. The guitars are heavy and iconic, from the Carvin and baritone guitars, giving you that thick, crunchy sound, to the Fender, Jaguar, and Telecaster guitars, which could go into the pop world. These are all recorded through amazing amplifiers from Fender, Bogner, Divide by 13, Carvin, Mesa Boogie, and Marshall. All of the classics. All of these instruments were played by top-notch musicians, such as Shane Gibson, who we know from Korn, Greg Suron, who is with Goo Goo Dolls and Avril Lavigne, Doug Rapoport, who played with Edgar Winner. The library also has the great Ashif Hakik, and in the drumming world, we have Tal Bergman, who played with Billy Idol, LL Cool J, Rod Stewart, you name it, and then Pierre Martin, who's a wonderful Los Angeles bass artist. So all of those musicians, all of these instruments, and we have other things like tempo synced performances and new scripting systems and all of that. There's a lot to look at. So let's just dive in. First things first, let's look at the library. So I go up to the browser here, and in the browser, you'll see we have basses, drums, and guitars. The way that it's organized is if we go into something like the basses, we'll have the main bass categories, and then within each category, like, say, Lackland bass with fingering instead of picking, we get the individual elements, or we can use key switches to allow us to pick between those elements, or we have these what are called playable patches, which will allow us to switch things via velocity. When we get back into drums and we check out the kits, you'll notice that there are kits, and then there are kits with less load. The less load are going to be a little easier on CPU and on your RAM. Then we have the large kits. And even in the large kits, we have regular snare patches, and then we have triple X snares. So depending on which one you want and how much complexity and sample loading you want, you can select between them. The kits are organized by drum kit. So we have the DW kits, the Gretsch kits, and the Ludwig kits. And within each one of those, we have different snares that we can choose. I'm going to come back to these in a second because it's very important to look at how the drum kits load. Under guitars, we have heavy guitars and rock pop guitars. When you get into the heavy guitars, we have, you know, baritone, Carvin, Gibson, Schecter. And we have lead guitars, which are used for soloing, and then we have rhythm guitars. What's kind of neat is not only do we have the elements, which are the individual articulations, and key switching and playable, we also have mod wheel controlled instruments, and then we have tempo sync performances, which if your DAW is feeding it the tempo information, it will play along with your DAW. So whatever tempo you're at, it will play along. So that's kind of fun. Go back to my Lackland bass here. So that's basically how the library is laid out. When I go into the player, on the left-hand side, we have things that we're very familiar with in the Play Engine. Delay, automatic double tracking, which is a way of having, it's simulating two instruments that have been recording the same line. But what it actually is exactly the same line being played back on a tape machine that has wow and flutter, which we can control using our delay, depth, spread, and level. We have reverb, filtering, we have an amp envelope, And over here, we have a drum mixer. We can mix together different elements, such as our close and overhead mics, our room mics, and our compressed room mics. We'll get into that when we talk about drum kits. Up here, we have our source selection, stereo mono, mono from left, mono from right, and then we have swap. That's going to be very important later as well. Down below is our host settings, output settings, MIDI, information, and all of the articulations on the right side. In the mixer gives us individual channels. Then we also have a channel for whatever instrument we happen to have here. This bass is only going to have one channel available. But when we get into something like a drum kit, you'll note that the mixer looks very different. We have kick drums, we have snares, we have hi-hats, toms, and cymbals. And within each one of those, if you click the faders here, you'll be able to mix the individual elements for that group. And we'll talk about that in a little bit. All right, let's start exploring these instruments. This is the infamous Lackland bass. It's being fingered. And we have a round robin going on here. So if you hit the same note twice, it's going to play different samples. So this is called the Lackland Skyline Standard Bass, and it was recorded through an Ampeg cabinet with an SVT rig, and a Sennheiser 421 dynamic mic was used to record it. Really great gear. Below that, we have the same bass, but it's being picked. Now you can hear just how much variation there is going on in there. There's a lot of really complex scripting going on. It sounds very good. This is the older Music Man Stingray that they had that's only available as picked. And this was recorded using an RCA 44 ribbon mic, and it was going through an Ampeg cabinet. Now on these basses so far, we've been going through the left and the right channel are the same. Later on, that's not going to be the case. Check out Music Man Vintage Open. So that sounds very, very good. Now below that, we have their new Music Man Stingray, and this is a whole different animal. Now we also have, they have Rickenbacker basses, they have Silvertone, they have fretless bass. All of those are available as well, but this new Music Man just sounds really excellent. It's got a lot of intelligent legato going on, so that the hammer-ons and everything sound very natural as you're playing through the bass. The left and the right side are different from each other. The right channel is an Ampeg amp, and the left channel is an SWR amp. So what you can do is you can choose between those by coming up here to the channel selector and choosing mono from right or mono from left. Then here we have check out the right channel. So that's pretty neat. And then if you want to get weird, you can go stereo. But then, of course, you'll get a little seasick. So the basses are really great. They took a lot of basses that they had from their previous libraries, the Hardcore and the XP library, and were able to remaster them for Ministry of Rock. And there is no lack of basses in this library. There are plenty. Okay, let's get down into the drums, because this is where things get a little bit more complicated. So let's go down here. I took a drummer from Logic, and I'm having it play this DW set. Check this out. Okay, first of all, let me turn that tempo down a bit. So that we have a DW kit that's playing a sonar snare. Check this out. First of all, let's go to the browser. In the browser, you'll see that on the left-hand side, it did not load just one instrument. It actually loaded five. We have kick drums, snares, hi-hats, toms, cymbals. When I select something like, say, the snares, and go into the player, you'll note that on the lower right-hand side, we have just the sonar and the DW cowbell, right? Well, if I want to, I can actually swap out that group of drums by going to grouped elements. And if I choose something like snares, then in the player, we'll be able to see all the different snares, and we could choose between them if we wanted to. If you have enough RAM, this is a great option because it allows you to mix and match your kit like crazy. I mean, you can really pretty much experiment with any combination of kit that you want. One thing that's important is to go up to the drum mixer in the upper right-hand side, and you'll see that all of these three mic types have been selected. It's good on your room mics to choose between the room and the compressed room. So what we're doing with these sliders is we're basically mixing the different microphones that were used to record the kit. So that's all room, and the room is being sent through a compressor to give it a really big fat sound. If we go through the regular room, sounds quite a bit different. And then we can pull up our overhead and close mics. So you can really adjust just how tight that kit's going to be. Now, I'm just messing with the snares right now. I'm not messing with the kick drum and all that sort of thing. Each one of those groups, so if we go to kick drum, that gets its own mixer. So if I pull this down and I go to snares, you'll notice that it's a different level. This can also be seen in your mixer. If you go to your mixer and you go to your kick drums and open up the faders for the kick drums, you can choose between the overhead and close mics, room, and compressed room. In addition to that, you also have all of these effects that you can place on just your kick group. So you have an individual SSL channel strip for the kicks, for the snares, for the toms, for the hi-hats and the cymbals. Pretty darn flexible. And again, if you go into the browser, you're able to load all of those groups if you want to and mix and match to your heart's content. You'll note that on the left-hand side, all of these groups are assigned to the same MIDI channel. So you're playing them all with the same instrument from your DAW. So just for grins, that was a DW with a sonar snare. Let's check out a Gretsch. Now what's also neat about this is you can have different reverbs on different groups as well. So there I just added a bunch of stage onto it. And just the snares too. So that's pretty fun and adds a lot of flexibility into the instrument. Coming down into the guitars start to get really interesting. Right now we have a baritone guitar here, and if I play it, we're using a key switching system on this one. There's our chugs, gradually getting shorter, and then we have tempo synced as well. So the key switch instruments basically have every single articulation you could want inside the instrument. Now, when we get down to the carven here, this is a carven guitar. It's being played, but you'll note on the upper left-hand side, it's actually got two groups loaded. And you'll note that only the right side is playing right now, and that's not in error. It's actually playing one of those groups. If I go to the browser and choose this group, you'll note that it plays only on the left side. So you get a whole separate player for the left and the right side tones. When it comes to the carven, both channels are going through a carven amp, so they don't sound that much different. But you can do a lot using the player for both groups to change the tone quite drastically between the right and the left side. So it's important when going through the Ministry of Rock 2 library to look at your groups and see how many groups have been loaded into an instrument. This Schecter 7 string, I really love how they worked on the scripting for this. When I play softly, I get chugs. When I play it hard, and then I get like a lead sound. When I pull the mod wheel up, when I play softly, instead of getting chugs, I'm getting full chords. So it's fun if you get used to it and you get used to the velocity in the mod wheel, you can really play this instrument in a really compelling way. You have all of your chugs, all of your power chords, and the lead all in one instrument, which is very, very interesting. So I suggest going into those mod and lead sounds and check them out. Coming down to the Jaguar, this is a pop guitar. And I did something kind of interesting. In Logic, I have the ability to create a scripter which has strumming capability. And what's neat about this particular library that we have open is this is a Jaguar, the Fender Jaguar that was kind of made popular by Nirvana. And they have a special library just for strums. And the strums, where you strum it on the guitar, is determined by the mod wheel. So it's kind of neat. If I strum it, it sounds pretty convincing. And all of the little details that happen when you strum, all the little noises and things like that come out. Every little squeak comes out. It's really, really nice. When we have a lead sound going along with it, the leads that you have in Ministry of Rock 2 are very, very versatile and easy to play. So in Ministry of Rock, not only you get the really heavy guitars, but you get some really nice pop guitars as well. Here's a nice telly sound. So you can hear when I play it arpeggiated, it sounds really nice, and that's because it's the strummed patch. Let me go to this telly lead sound. I'll play along with it. You know, classic spaghetti western sound with that telly. Very, very useful guitar. So that's the Ministry of Rock 2 library in a nutshell, and that's how you can navigate it. Once again, very, very important that you look when you load an instrument to see how many groups have been loaded, and go down to your articulations on the lower right-hand side and really play around with those. Also, be sure to go into your mixer and change all of your mixes with the drum groups as well, and swap out your drums. Have a lot of fun with Ministry of Rock 2. There's going to be a demo coming up here where everything is put together in a really cool way, and you'll hear just how powerful this instrument can be. When you put it into a mix, I, as a composer, I don't play guitar, and a lot of times I have to lean on this library to be able to deliver something that has guitars in it and not have people tell me that it's fake. That's the biggest thing about the Ministry of Rock series, is that it sounds so good. So I hope that you have a great experience with this library as well. And now I'd like to play you a demo where all of these instruments are put together in a really awesome way. Until our next cartoon, ciao.